indicating that it does reduce transmission.
One assistant professor at the University of British Columbia's School of Biomedical Engineering has been taking us inside her laboratory, right here behind me, to answer the questions people have about the COVID-19 vaccines, and she's been doing it using TikTok.
The whole idea is to connect scientists and clinicians who are working on COVID-19 to the general public over TikTok to be able to show them, here's what we do in the lab, here's how we make and test vaccines, and be able to answer any questions that they may have.
Dr. Blakeney was recruited to share her expertise on social media. It's a joint effort by the UN Verified Initiative and the Vaccine Confidence Project. She said at first she wasn't sure what to think about the idea, but now has over 200,000 followers.
I was very skeptical because I was like, I had never really been on TikTok before, and so I didn't really know the ins and outs of it other than just hearing that, you know, it's mostly young people.
What are some of the common misconceptions you see that really stand out to you?
Yeah, so probably the ones that I get the most often are just people often say, you know, is this vaccine rushed? So they see that it normally takes 5 to 10 years to develop a vaccine, and, you know, we were able to do it in 9 months and have multiple approved vaccines within a year of a brand new virus. The other one we get is, you know, are there any side effects or, you know, long-term safety effects from the vaccine? Now we have loads of safety data on the vaccines because of all the clinical trials, but they've also been, you know, administered to millions of people all over the world.
So now she's urging others like herself, clinicians and scientists, to get online and share their knowledge. She says she gets lots of questions and people are mostly receptive to the answers that she has.
I think people really enjoy seeing the science and what you do in a lab and all the equipment that we have. And so I think there's definitely a niche and a hunger for it there.
In the meantime, Dr. Blakeney is actually going to be setting up her brand new lab at UBC, where her work on vaccines will continue.
Can you just show us around what, I know it's all being set up, but like what is going to be in the future?
Yeah. It's very messy compared to what it would normally look like. So lots of shiny, very clean new equipment.
The centrifuge, what does that do?
So a centrifuge just spins everything around really quickly.
Thermocycler, what does that do?
So this is actually what we use to make RNA.
Spectrophotometer, what does that do?
So this is used for measuring the concentration of DNA or RNA in a solution.
Will you have side effects after your second dose if you had side effects after your first dose of COVID vaccine?
Can immunocompromised people take the vaccine?
If you get the Pfizer vaccine, can you then do a mixy-matchy and get the Oxford vaccine?
In Vancouver, David Zura, City News.